Good morning, children. Welcome to another class of math. We have finished with our first exercise of expansion, which was based on formulas, and where it was mostly the power was 2. Right? Now in this class, you can see that I've already jotted down the formulas for the second exercise, and what you can see over here is everywhere the index or the power is 3. So we have separated the exercise based on the power. The first one was on power raised to 2, and now it's power raised to 3. So let me take you one step by step 2 with all the formulas, and then we start with the application by starting with the exercise. The first formula over here is a plus b the whole cube. You need to just remember all these formulas, how you have remembered all the other formulas. It's all about memorizing them, by hearting them, and then applying them. So it's a plus b the whole cube. The formula is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab bracket a plus b. I'll repeat once again, a cube plus b cube plus 3ab bracket a plus b. You'll ask, ma'am, can you expand this? We have a bracket over here. I would say yes. We can expand by opening up the bracket. So I'll write that part also for you. So I'll erase this over here and I'll write down a cube plus b cube plus. Now I have 3ab. First term inside the bracket is a. So multiply 3ab into a. So a into a will become a square. So it becomes 3a square b plus. Now what I'm going to multiply? B and B. So 3A B into B will become B square. So the term becomes AB square. So you can write this formula in either of the way, the first one or the second one. In some of the sums, we'll be applying the first formula, and in some of the sums, we'll be applying the second formula. The second formula will be applying wherever we have question like expand using the formula. That time we'll use this, because if you have seen and noticed, we don't write the final answer in brackets whenever the expansion sums are there. We write open up all the brackets. So we'll be using this same way. Now we have the second formula which I had already written. Now I'll write it again for you. A minus B the whole cube. Very easy to remember. If you remember the first one, second one becomes very easy. I'll tell you how. Look at what I'm writing. What I have done? I have written all the terms exactly in the same place, right? What is the difference between the first and the second formula? Minus, 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 minus. Here everywhere it was plus, 3 plus, here we have 3 minus. That's it. So it's very easy to remember the formula. I usually remember this one. So automatically this comes. We have to only change the sign to minus everywhere. So when I open up this bracket, I get a cube minus b cube minus 3 a square b plus 3 ab square. I would say if you don't remember this formula, it's okay if you remember this, because we know how to open up the bracket and multiply. So the less we remember, less number of formulas we remember, it's better. Not less we remember, less number of formulas we remember, it's better. So we stick to the basic, this one and this one. Right? So we have our two formulas ready. Now based on this, we have the third and the fourth. Now what's the difference between the first and the third? In first, we had A plus B. We had A plus B. That means we are talking about two different terms. Here in the third one, if I write this as first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and sixth. Now, if you look at the third one and the first one, here what is B? It is nothing but the reciprocal of A. That's it. So very simple. So wherever B is there, I write the reciprocal of A, which is 1 upon A. So I have A cube plus 1 upon A cube plus. Here I didn't write AB. Why I didn't write AB? Because B is what? It is nothing but 1 upon A. So, if I write 3 into 3AB. So, 3 into A into B. Tuck, tuck gets cancelled. So, what remains? Only 3. And brackets A plus 1 upon A. Right? Clear everybody? Good. Same way with the fourth formula. Fourth is similar to what? Fourth is similar to the second one. Where the sign is minus. So A minus 1 upon A the whole cube is what? A cube minus 1 upon A cube minus 3 brackets A minus 1 upon A. So it's just the same like the third one. The difference is what? Everywhere instead of plus we have written minus. That's it. Nothing else. So I hope the first four formulas are thorough with you. Great. Now let's look at the fifth and the sixth. Now fifth and sixth are actually appearing in the first and the second as well. The terms. A cube plus B cube, I can see over here. A cube minus B cube, I can see over here. Right? So sometimes you might have questions where you have A cube plus B cube to solve or A cube minus B cube to solve. So, we have another formula, that is A plus B, first bracket, second bracket is A square minus AB plus B square. Now children, please be very careful. We have a habit. Our mind runs very fast. Does this not strike you like familiar or similar to something else? Our favorite formula, A minus B, the whole square. But what is the middle term over there? It's 2AB and here it's just minus AB. So don't get confused. Ma'am, can I write this as A minus B the whole square? No, you can't, because the middle term over here doesn't have 2. It is minus AB. So you can't factorize this or write it in any other form. So the formula of A cube plus B cube is A plus B. Second bracket, A square minus AB plus B square. I again remember the fifth formula. Because sixth is easy to remember if I remember the fifth one. Why? How? Look at the sign. It's A cube minus B cube. If you compare both the terms inside the brackets in both the formulas, they all are exactly the same. A plus B, A and B, A and B. A square is A square, AB is AB, B square is B square over here. So terms are exactly the same. The signs change, vary. How do I remember that? Remember, whenever it's A cube plus B cube, the first bracket will have plus sign and the second bracket middle term will have a minus sign. And when it's A cube minus B cube, then the first bracket has a negative sign. And the second bracket has all terms positive. That's the only difference. So it's easy for you to remember. I always think, even now, when I have to apply the formula, oh, A cube minus B cube means my first bracket is going to be minus. And all the terms in the second bracket is going to be positive. Simple. So that's how I remember this formula. And if it helps you, you can remember it like that. So our second exercise is majorly based on these six formulas which we'll be applying in our second exercise. I hope it is clear with everybody. Anybody has any doubt? No, I can't see any doubt in the chat section or anywhere. So we'll continue with our sums. Okay, so we will go to exercise 3B. And we start with the first, second part. So I'll write over here, exercise 3B, first, second part. Now first, second part. First question, completely six subparts are there. And it's all about expand. That means we have to write the, it's using the expansion formula, we have to expand. Now the question is, 2p minus 3q the whole cube. It's 2p minus 3q the whole cube. So obviously I know which formula we have to apply, right? I have two terms with a minus sign inside the bracket and raised to 3. So I have to apply the formula a minus b the whole cube. First I write down the formula, right? So a minus b the whole cube, the formula becomes a cube minus b cube minus 3 a square b plus 3 ab square. Okay, this is my formula. So as I have been telling you, every time, every sum, we have to write down the formula so that it becomes easy for me to solve. Now I can compare this with my question. So A is nothing but 2P and B is nothing but 3Q. So wherever A comes in the right hand side, I'll be putting 2P, and wherever B comes, I'll be putting it as 3Q. So let's start doing that. 2P, always remember bracket is important. So write down 2P the whole cube inside the bracket, 3Q inside the bracket, A square. So 2P the whole square into 3Q plus 3, 2P into 3Q the whole square. Now what do? Just simplify, raised to 3, it's inside the bracket. So I'll remove the bracket. So it's 2 cube into p cube. 2 cube is 8. So 8p cube minus 3 cube is 27q cube minus. Now it's 2p the whole square. So 2 into 2 becomes 4. 4 into 9. 4 into 9 becomes 36p square cube. Plus, now it's 3 square. 3 square is 9. 9 into 6. 2 threes are 6. So 9 into 6 becomes 54p cube square. And this is my final answer. I hope everybody has understood this and got the correct answer as well. Yes, Ariman, you have got the correct answer. And I hope everybody else has also got the correct answer. Okay, now if you have understood this, please go on and do question number one, third part, which is 2x plus 1 upon 3x the whole cube. Which formula will we apply? The first or the third? Is 1 upon 3x the reciprocal of 2x? No. So we will take the first one only, the first formula, right? Because we have a plus sign over here. So please continue with the answer and I'll check on with you in a minute whether you have got the correct answer. Rucha, I'm not able to unmute you, Vita. I was trying to do that. I can see your hand raised. You can write your answer. I could unmute you. Bolo, Vita.
Ma'am, this happens when I have muted myself, so it asks me if I want to unmute or no, if you try to
okay.
unmute.
Okay. I saw your hand raised. What happened?
Ma'am, I used the second formula only, but I used the first one, that is minus 3.
This one.
No, the second formula, but the unopened one.
Chalega. I said na, both is perfectly fine. But remember, when it's expand, do not write the answer in bracket form. So you need to open up.
Yes, I opened it. I got the same answer.
Yes, that's perfectly fine. Not an issue. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Lower your hand. Sharukesh, do you have a doubt? Your hand is raised.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, I want to answer actually.
Okay. Give me 2 minutes, okay? Let everybody finish and then I'll ask and we will cross check, okay? First step, write down the formula. So it's a plus b the whole cube is a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square. I'll write on the other side of the board now. Okay, so then let me check with Sharukesh and see whether all are getting the same answer. Yes, Sharukesh, please tell me the answer which you have got.
Ma'am, it's 8x cube plus 1 by 27 x cube.
Okay.
Plus 4x plus 2 by 3x.
Plus 4x plus 2 by
3x.
Is this the same answer everybody getting? Very good. Aman, beta, it was 3x the whole cube. So it will be 27x cube. Remaining terms are right. Good. Great job. So now, anybody wants to, any doubt or should I proceed to the next sum? Okay, next sum. Great. So next we are doing is question number one, sixth part. Question number one, sixth part. You can start doing it. I have two hands raised. I'll answer them. Those who don't have the question, I'll read it for you. Bracket x upon 2 minus 2y upon 3 the whole cube. I'll read it again. X by 2 minus 2 by 3, 2y upon 3 the whole cube. Anushka, what's the doubt?
Ma'am, it will be 4x square if I'm not wrong.
No, beta. No, it won't be 4x square because there is an x below. If you see, it is 4x square upon 3x. Right?
Okay. Yeah.
So that 3 gets cancelled and x square upon x. So we have only x.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Kushal, you have now got the answer, beta, or you are still having doubt? Got the answer. Very good, Kushal. So now, the sixth part is x upon 2 minus 2y upon 3 the whole cube. So the formula I'll apply is a minus b the whole cube, a cube minus b cube, 3 a square b. I've written the formula. I'll wait for somebody to give me the answer. Indraneel has raised his hand. Let me see, this is it for doubt or for the answer? Indraneel?
Ma'am, actually, I want to it's not x by 2, it's 1 by 2x and 2 by 1 by 2x.
I understood, beta, but 1 into x is x. 2 into y is 2y. Oh. That's why I wrote it like that. Okay? Yes, Mohika?
Ma'am, I have the answer.
You have the answer. You want to share the answer. Okay, great. So, you tell me the answer and we'll cross check whether everybody is getting the same answer. So, tell me, Vita, I'll write it down.
Of 1 by 8x cube minus
minus
1 by 2 x square y.
Okay.
Plus 2 by 3 x y square.
Okay.
Minus 8 by 27 y cube.
Is this what I have written on the board, same as what you have told me? Just cross check with the board. You had said 1 by 8 x cube. So that means x cube was super, right?
No. No. That's wrong. The first one is 1 by 8 and side x cube.
Beta, to 1 into x cube is x cube. So, writing 1 by 8 into x cube is same as x cube upon 8. Got it?
Yeah, correct.
Yes, okay. Great, I can see over here Shalini has got the same answer, I think. All the variables over here are in the numerator. It's only the numbers in the denominator. Yes, good. Unni, do you have a doubt, Beta? Anushka's hand is raised. Let me check. No, Anushka's hand. Anushka has lowered her hand. Shalini? Nahi. Aryaman? Is your hand raised? For a doubt? Okay.
Ma'am, in the sixth one, sixth part.
Yes, Victor.
Ma'am, I got the answer as x cube by 8 minus 8y cube upon 27 minus x square y plus xy square.
What about the denominator x? I didn't get you. So first and second parts were right. What about the third part? What did you say?
X square y plus xy square.
X square y. Where did the denominator ka 2 go? Cross check again. This is the correct answer which is given by Mohika. If anybody has a doubt, I will solve the sum for you. Not an issue with me. There are many things. Remember, bracket me. It is x by 2 the whole square. So it will become x square upon 4. See? It's okay. We make mistake and we learn from it. Not an issue. Correct it. Okay? Laksh over here. Beta, you have a doubt?
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I've got almost the same answer. But the values are interchanged.
The position is interchanged. Are you saying? That's perfectly fine. Position interchange is not an issue. The sign should be same in front of the term. That is important.
Sign is same.
Okay, great. I have got a 2-3 children asking me, ma'am, can you solve the answer? Definitely, I can solve the answer since they are having doubt. So I'll solve this answer. Okay. I'll write it down on this side. And those who have done and want to go ahead, can solve question number 3 if you want. And others can wait, listen to the explanation, and then we'll move ahead together. Okay, so I'll solve this sum for you guys. Now I'm applying the formula a minus b the whole cube. So it will be x by 2 the whole cube. Minus 2y by 3 the whole cube, 3x by 2 the whole square into 2y by 3 plus 3x by 2 and 2y by 3 the whole square. Okay, now this will become x cube upon 8 minus 8y cube upon 27. This is pretty simple. So I have written this. Now, minus 3. First bracket is x square upon 4. And second bracket is 2y upon 3. Here 3, x upon 2 and this is 4y square upon 9. I have only simplified the exponent wala form so that now I can do my katakuti or the cancellation. So if you see, the 3 gets cancelled, 2 and 4, so this becomes 2. Here I can cancel 3 and 9, this is 3. And here I can cancel 2 and 4, which is 2. So what is the answer I get? I get x cube upon 8 minus 8y cube upon 27 minus. Now numerator, there is no number, all got cancelled. So what remains is x square y upon denominator, it's only 2. And here I have plus. If you see, I have 2 over here. I have x, I have y square upon 3, which is the same answer which is written over here, told by Mohika. Only the arrangement of the terms are different. Otherwise, the answer is exactly the same. So I hope those who didn't get have understood it. Shalini, how it will be plus beta for this? If you remember, this is minus b cube. So the last term will be minus 8y cube upon 27 only. Himansh has a doubt. Ma'am, in the answer key given by you, the answer is 8y cube upon 27, while when we got minus of the same term. You mean to say, children, sometimes the answers behind are wrong. If they are wrong, don't worry, I'll let you know. This is the correct answer. Okay, great. So now we will move on. I have got few answers saying ki, children saying ki they have understood. So that means I can now confidently move ahead to the third question. The third question is given if 3x minus 2y is 5. Okay, so they have given to me if 3x minus 2y equal to 5. So I'll write it in the form of given and to find. So third question, given 3x minus 2y is 5 and xy is 6. I have to find the value of 27x cubed minus 8y cubed. Yes, Aman and Sharukesh have got the correct answer. Bingo. Good job. Okay, now, how do we solve this? If you see, this is, these two things are given to me and this is to be found out. If you see the relation between what is to be found out and this left-hand side of the equation, 3x the whole cube will give me what? Krishna, Unni? Your answer is wrong. Mohika and Rucha, Shalini have got the correct answer. So, 3x the whole cube is 27x cube and 2y the whole cube is 8y cube. That means obviously I have to cube this equation, cubing on both the sides. Okay, so let's start. 3x minus 2y the whole cube. If I cube on one side, I have to cube the other side as well. So, it's 5 cubed. So this, I'll apply the formula, right? So here I'll apply which formula? I'll apply the formula a minus b the whole cube is equal to a cube minus b cube minus 3ab a minus b. Why do you think I use this formula and not the other one? Because if you see, I have ab term, the product term, and here also I have got the product term. I can use the other formula, not an issue. But this will fetch me faster correct answer. Right? So let's start. I will write now a is 3x and b is 2y. So 3x cube minus 2y the whole cube minus 3. 3x 2y. 3x minus 2y. What is 5 cube equal to? 5 cube is 125. 5 5 is 25. 25 into 5, 125. Right? So now I open up the bracket. So what do I get? get 27x cube minus 8y cube minus. Children, remember its formula and the correct substitution. AB was there, its correct substitution is 3x and 2y. It's not just x and y. Here, A is 3x and B is 2y. This is the most common area where my children used to go wrong. So I'm telling you again, Shreya, you've got the correct answer. So here, 3 into 3 into 2. 9 twos are 18. So 18xy, 3x minus 2y equal to 125. Now, if you check out, xy is given to me as 6. 3x minus 2y is given to me as 5. So that means I know here both these terms, right? So I will write 27x cube minus 8y cube is equal to 125. Minus on the other side becomes plus 18 into 5 into 6. I have just substituted the values which were given. Xy was given as 6 and 3x minus 2y is given as 5. So 6, 5 is 30. 30 into 18 becomes 540. So it is 125 plus 540, which when you add will give you 665, which most of you have already got the answer. So the correct answer is 665. I hope it is clear with everybody. Very good. Good job. I don't see any hands raised. That means everybody has got the correct answer. Good job. Now you can do question number 4. Try doing it on your own. Try doing the question number 4 on your own. I'll write it on the board over here. Fourth question is given. If A plus 3B is 6, they are given A plus 3B is 6. Show that. So here we don't have to find. We have to show that. So I will write TST. TST full form to show that. I have to show that A cube plus 27B cube plus 54AB is equal to 216. So I need to get this expression. This is similar to your third sum. Proceed exactly in the same way and try to get the answer. I'll wait for 2 minutes for you to solve on your own. Okay? By that time, I'll take a small water break. I can see all at work, everybody doing it diligently. I can see that. Good job. Drisha, the board is pretty good, bitter. Once you are done with the sum, just give a thumbs up sign that you have understood. And for somebody who is not getting, you can tell that as well in the chat. TST, beta, to show that. TST is to show that. Good. Rohan, Shalini, Sibangi, Vedanti have all shown the thumbs up sign. That means they are getting the answer. Good job. Moika has also got the answer. So I'll wait for you all. Mayuk has got it. Let me flip through my other pages and check out my other children. Can we use it using LHS and RHS? In this sum, Himansh, I don't think so you'll be able to use the LHS and RHS over here. It would be better if we solve it together. Okay? Here I can see many have switched off their recordings, the videos. I want all of you to switch on the video. I can see very clearly. I don't want calling out names. I want the screens because I want to check out my children, what they are doing. Yes. Gives a good feeling for me as a teacher that my children are solving along with me. Third page also many I can see without their video on. Request all of you to turn on your video. Otherwise, if I turn off my video, what do you think will happen? Will you like it? Okay, I have a child requesting me to solve. So no problem, I'll start solving. And those who have got can do question number 6 if you want, no compulsion. Otherwise, I'm there to solve. Okay, now here I can see a cube plus 27 b cube. That means a plus 3b, the whole cube made. These two will be my first two terms. So what I do is I proceed in the same way as I did the previous sum. I cube both the sides of my given equation and I apply my formula. Again, I'll write down the formula. A plus b the whole cube is a cube plus b cube plus 3ab bracket a plus b. And now my a is a and b is 3b. So here I'll write a cube plus 3b the whole cube plus a 3a bracket 3b a plus 3b and 6 cube happens to be 216. So it's a cube plus 27b cube. And here I have 3 into 3. How much is that? 6. And a plus 3b is how much? It is also 6. Right? So 3 into 3 is 9. 9 into 6 is 54ab is equal to 216, which is what was asked to be shown. I have just substituted a plus 3b as 6. And multiply 3 into 3, 9, 9 into 6 will be 54. And this A and B written over here. Is it clear? Those who had the doubt, is it clear? You didn't understand from the third step. Third step is this. Okay, if you want, I'll write one more step. Not a problem at all. A cube plus 27B cube. Plus 3 into 3, 9ab. And what is a plus 3b given to me? It is 6. So a cube plus 27b cube, 9, 6 are 54. ab is 216. Got it? Good. Very good. Now, let's start with the 6 sum, everybody. Rohan got the correct answer. Good job. Sixth answer, Rohan has already solved and he has got the correct answer. I am slow. I will write it down. Don't worry. The sixth question is given. X plus 1 upon X is 3. And they have asked us to find X cube plus 1 upon X cube. Obviously, it will be which formula? The third one, right? A plus 1 upon A the whole cube. So, let's write. Yes, Shalini, Mohika, I've all got the answer correct. Himansh also got correct. Answer is 18. So, I will write X plus 1 upon X the whole cube is 3 cube. Now here, I'll write the formula. A plus 1 upon A the whole cube is A cube plus 1 upon A cube plus 3 A plus 1 upon A. The formula comes in bracket and then I write. Now, only difference in the formula and this sum is, in place of A, we have X. Right, Sridhar? Very good. Correct answer. 18. So, I write X cube plus 1 upon X cube plus 3. X plus 1 upon X is equal to 3 cube is 27. So, X cube plus 1 upon X cube plus 3. X plus 1 upon X is 3. 3 threes are 9. So, I get plus 9 on the other side becomes minus 9. And the answer is 18. Pretty simple. Everybody? Yes, Shreya, it is. 18 is the correct answer. Manasvi, correct answer. Mayuk, correct answer. Good job. So now you can start solving question number 8 on your own. I'll wait for you. I'll write down the question on the board for you all, but you will solve on your own. Okay? So let's start. That is question number 8. It is given to me. X minus 2 upon X is given as 6. And I have to find what? I have to find X cube minus 8 upon X cube. So obviously, we know the first step is cubing both the sides. And then apply the formula. Now here, should I apply A minus 1 upon A, the formula, or A minus B? Yes, A minus B. Why? Because X ka reciprocal is not 2 upon X. X ka reciprocal is 1 upon X. So the formula is A minus B, the whole cube, A cube minus B cube minus 3A square B plus 3AB square. Or if you want, you can use the other one. I'll use the other formula. Minus 3AB bracket A minus B. Use this formula and get the answer. I will wait for all of you to get me the correct answer. Manasvi, Rohan have got the correct answer. Sharkesh, wrong answer. Simple calculation mistake. Very simple calculation mistake. Shalini got the correct answer. Mayuk got the correct answer. Unni, right. Mohika, right. Sharkesh, I'm sure you must have understood the mistake which you have made. Ishita, correct. Aman, correct. Panchika, same mistake as Sharukesh, and I'll confess, even I made the same mistake yesterday. That calculation, that's why I said, I know. Don't worry, children, before you, I come to the class, I solve all the sums. So even I made the same mistake. Shreya, correct answer. Vedanti, correct answer. Panchika, one small mistake. Drishya, what is the answer, Vita? Panchika now has got it right. So I am wrong. Niranjana right, Charukesh right, Ashka right. Wow. Feeling happy. Ritika right. Akshat right. Sayam, no Bitu, wrong answer. Check the silly calculation mistake. Nishchal, Sumit, correct answer. Shreyas, correct answer. Arya, correct answer. No, Aratrika Vita, wrong answer. The correct answer, I'll read it out now. It is 252. Please check your answer again. 252 is the correct answer. I know you will be able to get it. Don't worry. It's just a small calculation mistake which has gone wrong here or there. I'm sure you will get it. Kushal, very good, Bita. Anushka, when I solve, then you will be like, I can make such mistakes? Oh God, that will be your expression. So before that, I want you to try find it out the mistake yourself. I know you can do it. That's a small calculation mistake. Indraneel, correct answer. Good. Remember, 3ab. So 3 into x into 2 upon x. That's one place where we can go wrong. Swayam, bingo. Correct answer. These are small, small places where we can go wrong. I'm sure Anushka must have found out her mistake. And for those who want to go ahead, can solve question number 10. Anybody who wants me to solve? Anushka, do you still want me to solve? So I will solve. I wanted to give you a chance first. Aratrika Bita, you got the correct answer? Got the correct answer? Good. I can read the 10th sum. I was just waiting for Anushka to confirm. Can I write the next sum? Okay. Yes, see, I told you, Anushka. I knew you will get it. Okay, let's start. Ariman is still stuck somewhere in that same sum. Okay, don't worry, Ariman. I'm there both with you. I'll read the 10th sum for the others and then I'll come back to you. Don't worry. 10th sum is given a square plus 1 upon a square is 23. I'll write it down as well, given and to find. Okay, so 10th sum, it says given a square plus 1 upon a square is 23. And you have to find two parts are there. The first part is a plus 1 upon a. And the second part is a cube plus 1 upon a cube. Ariman, stuck over here? Okay, chalo, let's do it. Oh my God. Mayuk and Sharukesh are giving me the answers already. And Mayuk has got the correct answer. Nahin. Second time mein correct answer hai Mayuk. First answer was wrong. And Sharukesh answer... Mayuk, both the answers are right. Good job. You have given me two different answers in two parts. Now wait. Let me first clear with Ariman. I'm not going to read the chat section now. Ariman, chalo, let's do it together. So A is X and B is 2 upon X, right? So it is X cube minus 2 upon X the whole cube minus 3x, 2 upon x, x minus 2 upon x is equal to 6 cube, which is 216. Right, Ariman? I cancel my x over here. This is x cube minus 8 upon x cube. And here I get minus 2, 3s are 6. Now, x minus 2 upon x is what, Ariman? It is 6. So I write 6 over here is 216. So x cube minus 8 upon x cube minus on the other side will become plus. So I will have 216 plus 36. So 252 is the correct answer. Got it, Ariman? Good job. And for the others, I think I'll solve the first sum, that is the 10th sum, and similar variety you can do on your own. Okay? So, all of you can pay attention over here. The 10th sum. It's given a square plus 1 upon a square as 23. And they have asked us to find a plus 1 upon a. Have we solved this type of sum in our previous exercise? Yes, we have. So, we will apply the previous knowledge and we will start with the solution by writing a plus 1 upon a the whole square formula. It was a square plus 1 upon a square plus 2. Right? This was the formula. Now what is a plus 1 upon a square plus 1 upon a square? They have already given it to me as 23 plus 2 turns out to be 25. So a plus 1 upon a, the whole square is 25. So tell me, what will be the answer of a plus 1 upon a? Will it be only 5 or will it be plus or minus 5? Perfect. Right answer. It is plus or minus 5. So that's the first answer. Plus or minus 5 is the first part answer. Now, let's go on to do the second part. Now, second part, what does it say? It asks us a cube plus 1 upon a cube. Now, we know this. We have done so many sums based on this formula. But if you see over here, I have got a plus 1 upon a. In the previous sums, wherever we have solved, we had only 1, 5 or 3 or whatever it was. Here we have got two answers, plus 5 and minus 5. So what we will do is, for no further confusion, we will do it as two separate cases. Okay? So in case 1, I will take the value of a plus 1 upon a as 5. So, second, this was first part. Second part, I'll write a case 1. A plus 1 upon a is given to me as plus 5. So, what do? I cube both the sides. So, I get a plus 1 upon a, the whole cube, is equal to 5 cube. Now, you know how to proceed with this sum. This is what was little different. Solving it as two different cases for your better understanding. So, I will write it as now a cube plus 1 upon a cube plus 3 a plus 1 upon a into 125. So, a cube plus 1 upon a cube is 125. A plus 1 upon a, I already know in this case, is 5. 5 into 3, 15. But there's a plus sign. When I take it on the other side, minus 15. So 125 minus 15 is how much? 110. So in case 1, I got the answer as 110. Now I'll consider my case 2. In case 2, I'll take a plus 1 upon a as minus 5. Now, I will cube both the sides. Method and the steps remain the same. Only here, to avoid confusion, plus or minus cubing and all, we have now minus 5, the whole cube means minus 5 into minus 5 into minus 5 will give me the answer minus 125. So, a cube plus 1 upon a cube is minus 125. And here my plus 1 upon a is what? It's minus 5. So minus 5 into 3 is minus 15. Then I take it on the other side, becomes plus 15. And again, I get my answer as 110 with the negative sign ahead. So now I club both my cases and I write down the final answer as, therefore, a cube plus 1 upon a cube is plus or minus 110. Understood? So, there is no confusion whatsoever when we do it in two cases rather than writing plus or minus 5. Then there's a confusion. Should I take plus 5 cube or minus 5 cube? We avoid all that by taking two cases. And they end up with the same answer. The signs are different. Anukrishna, please check your answer better. Both the answers, its number is same. The signs are different. Plus or minus 110 is the correct answer. You have written 140 and minus 110. That's why I am asking you better. Aman, I can see your hand raised. Yes, Aman.
I had it out, but it got cleared.
Got cleared. Okay, great. In exam, we have to show both the methods. Yes, Ovia, we have to show both the methods. Both the cases. Aiden has a doubt. How did you get minus 5? Beta, Aiden, 1, A plus 1 upon A is plus or minus 5. It says it can have two answers. It will be plus 5 or it will be minus 5. So there are two answers in my first subpart. So that's why I have two cases. First case with plus 5 and second case with minus 5. That's how I got minus 5. And how I got plus or minus 5? Because it was root of 25. Remember the first exercise, every time, root, whenever it comes, there are two answers. Right? I hope it is clear, Aiden. Okay, great. Arivan, do you have a doubt? Your hands is raised. Okay. Yes, Arivan.
In the exam, we can write any one of the cases, right?
You have to write both the cases.
Okay.
Yeah. Otherwise, if you don't mind, I will also give you only one mark out of two. Chalega? So both the should be there, okay? Anybody else has doubt? Okay, Kushal has a doubt. What sum to do next? Kushal is full enthusiastic. So I don't want to waste this time. Kushal, we will start with question number 11. We'll start with question number 11. Rucha, do you have a doubt? I can see hand raised, but I can't see on my screen. If you don't have a doubt, lower your hand. If you have a doubt, keep it up. Yes, Rucha.
Ma'am, instead of A plus 1 upon A, instead of doing twice, I substituted it with plus or minus 5.
I know better, that's what I said, but it's always better to do it both the cases. Sometimes we might make mistake, we might get confused. I always tell you guys to reduce the number of steps, but here, if you get into confusion, you'll get the wrong answer. Here, it's pretty easy. That's why. Got it?
Okay.
Okay. Ariman and Rucha, I can lower the hand because I've cleared your doubts. Akshat, somebody else is typing for you? Or is it some language which I'm supposed to learn? Okay. So now it's question number 11. Mayuk is on a roll today. With the first part correct answer, Mohika also first part correct answer. I will write down the question number 11 now. Okay. Question number 11 says, if A minus 1 upon A is root 5, A minus 1 upon A is root 5, and we have to find the value of first A plus 1 upon A. And second part is A cube plus 1 upon A cube. Now children, again, if you look at the first part and the given, we have already solved this type of sum in first exercise. Do we have a formula connecting these two in bracket? If you remember. Yes, Rucha has got the correct answer for the second part as well. Mayuk, wrong answer, second part. Rohan has got the correct answer for the second part as well. Here the formula was this, which we did in the first exercise. A plus 1 upon A, the whole square minus A minus 1 upon A, the whole square. Answer is 4. Vedanti has got the second part answer right. Swayam, 7 is for which part? I don't know. And it's wrong answer, Vita. First part answer. So now I substitute. I don't know this. So I'll keep it as it is. This I know as root 5 the whole square. So A plus 1 upon A the whole square is 4 plus root 5 into root 5 becomes 5. Minus sign on this side, the other side becomes plus 5, 9. So what is the value? value of a plus 1 upon a. If a plus 1 upon a, the whole square is 9. What is a plus 1 upon a? It is plus or minus 3. Now the same method, case 1, you will take it as plus 3, and case 2, you will take it as minus 3. Sam, wrong answer. Manasvi has got the first part answer right. Mayuk has got the second part answer right now. Shalini, both part, both cases you need to show. I'm not doing the second part. I'm taking a water break. I hope you guys are also taking water in between. Drink water. No, Manasvi. Beta, second part answer is wrong. Shreya, two parts, both answers should be plus minus should be there. You have only given me 18 as answer. Aratrika, correct answer. Mohika, correct answer. The second part answer is plus or minus 18. Second part answer is plus or minus 18. You need to show both the cases, case 1 and case 2. Case 1 will be when a plus 1 upon a is 3. And case 2 will be when a plus 1 upon a is taken as minus 3. Good job, Sridhar. Very well done. Proud of you. Don't worry, I'll give you time. I'll wait for you guys to finish off. Those who have done and have got the textbook or the question can start with the 14 sum. Can start with the 14 sum. Manasvi, sorry ma'am, some calculation. Right, Manasvi. Ashka, with a plus and minus 18. Remember, both should be there. Akshat, right answer. Ovia, first part right, second part again. For those who haven't got the textbook or the question written, I'll read it for you. Given is x plus 1 upon x, the whole square is 3. X plus 1 upon x, the whole square is 3. And you have to show that x cube plus 1 upon x cube is 0. You have to show that x cube plus 1 upon x cube is 0. Very simple answer. Anybody has any doubt in this sum, let me know. I'll help you out. Otherwise, I will write the next. Okay. Manshika has raised her hands. Yes, Manshika Bita.
Ma'am, I have a doubt in the 12th question.
Where did you reach 12th? 12th is a homework.
To the 11th one then.
Then the 11th one. The 11th one is what I have solved the first part of the board.
Yeah, the first part. Ma'am, yeah. In that, how did you get the root 5 square as 5?
Yeah, root 5 into root 5. Third, 8th grade. Chapter, square and square roots. Forgot? Root 5 into root 5 is 5.
Okay, ma'am.
Remember that. Anybody else doubt? Should I write the next question on the board? That is the 14th one. Can I proceed? Ariman, are you able to solve the 11th one? Got it? Chalo, then I'll write the 14 since I have not got any doubt in the chat box or in the hand raise section. So let's start. 14 fun. Putting sum is given x plus 1 upon x the whole square is 3. To show that TST is to show that x cube plus 1 upon x cube is 0. Now obviously I know x cube plus 1 upon x cube I will get when I cube x plus 1 upon x. So I need x plus 1 upon x, and here they have given me x plus 1 upon x the whole square as 3. So what do you think my first step should be? If x plus 1 upon x the whole square is 3, what is the answer of x plus 1 upon x? What is the answer? X plus or minus root 3. Now, I'm sure you'll be able to solve it. Case 1. X plus 1 upon x is root 3. You cube both the sides. You will get x cube plus 1 upon x cube plus 3. X plus 1 upon x. 3 root 3 cube. Root 3 cube, children, means what? Root 3 into root 3 into root 3. What is the answer? Who would like to answer this part? Please raise your hand. I'm not going to answer. I want you to answer. I can see Anu Krishna. Yes, Vita. Root 3 the whole cube.
It will be 3 only.
It will be 3 only. Pakka?
Yeah.
Let me check with somebody else. Okay. I had Indraneel over here who had raised his hands. Yes, Indraneel?
3 only.
3 only. Again. Swayam has given me another answer. 3 root 3. Aidan has given me answer 9. Kushal 9. I will go with Swayam. Correct answer given by Swayam. It is 3 root 3. But chalo, remember, it is root 3 into root 3 into root 3. I am multiplying root 3 3 times. First 2, root 3 into root 3, answer is 3. And root 3 over here. So root 3, the whole cube. Answer is 3 root 3. Understood, Indraneel, Anul Krishna, and all the others? Good. So here I'll write 3 root 3. So now I'll erase this side of the board. So it becomes x cube plus 1 upon x cube, 3 root 3, and here it was plus 3 bracket x plus root x. X plus root x was root 3. So on the other side when I take it becomes 3 root 3. Answer is 0. Case 1, I've got answer 0. Please solve case 2 on your own. I want both the cases to be solved and I'm damn sure both the answers will be 0. Those who have done can do the last sum of the day. And of the exercise, that is question number 16, first part. And others, complete the second case and then we start with 16, second part. If you are done with, show the thumbs up hand so that I can continue. Indraneel has raised his hand. Yes, Indraneel.
Are you saying 16 to 15? Because there's 15 questions only.
No, Beta, the PDF which I had sent, PDF form, that had total 17 sums, which is the latest book. So don't worry, you wait for 2 minutes. I will write down the 16th first part. And please check the PDF which I have sent on 9th April. It has still 17 questions.
Okay, ma'am. No. Okay, ma'am.
Yeah. Were you able to get the second case as well? Zero? Everybody? Great. Very good. And you can see that we are in the last few sums. And till now, we have only used the first four formulas which we wrote. What about the other two? Now, the last two formulas come into picture in your 16th sum. 16th sum, I'll read it for you. It says, find the product using suitable identities, right? So using suitable identities, so this is the sum I've written on the board. I'll read it out for you. It is 3a plus 4b in first bracket. And second bracket, it is 9a square minus 12ab plus 16b square. You remember this one? Which formula? Is it similar to the fifth or the sixth one? Fifth one, right? Because the first bracket has plus sign and the second bracket middle term is minus sign. So how do we find the product? I'll tell you the answer. Yes, Rohan, you've got the correct answer. Same as Shalini. But how do we write? I'll show the step over here. 3a plus 4b is the simplified form. Now here, 9a square, I'll write 3a the whole square. 12ab. 12ab. Can I write 3a into 4b and 16b square, can I write it as 4b the whole square? Right? So if you see, this resembles which formula? This resembles the formula a cube plus b cube is a plus b a square minus ab plus b square. And what I have written over here resembles the right hand side of the formula. Aiden, I am doing question number 16, first part. So here if you see, you might have an old edition book. If you have got, the new edition has question number till question number 17. So if you see over here, 3a is in place of a, 4b is in place of b. A square ke jagah you have 3a square. In place of ab, you have 3a into 4b. And b square is nothing but 4b the whole square. So, what do? I write the answer as what? It is a cube plus b cube. What is my a over here? 3a. So, 3a the whole cube and 4b the whole cube. So, the answer is what? 3a is cube is 27a cube plus 4 cube is 64b cube. So the answer is 27a cube plus 64b cube. I hope it is clear with all. Those who have a textbook with you, it might be old edition because you have got it from your friends. That's perfectly fine. Here we have total 17 questions. We have done till question 16, first part. Question 17, there's a similar sort and example. So please go through the example also and you'll be able to solve question number 17. Okay, so do that. The homework sums are the ones which you have not done today in class. Question number 15 has hint given. So you can make use of the hint and you can continue with that sum as well. Okay. I'll write it down, whatever it's the homework, classwork, again in the WhatsApp group for your benefit. And I can see Anushka here with a doubt. Anushka, yes?
Ma'am, in the question 14, case 2, it will be minus root 3 the whole cube, which is root 3.
Right. And on the other side, you will have plus 3 into minus root 3. So on the other side also, you get minus 3 root 3. When you bring it on this side, it becomes plus 3 root 3. So you get the answer as 0.
Okay. Yes. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. Yes, anybody else has any doubt? I can see Nishchal over here. Where are you, Nishchal? Yes,
ma'am. Ma'am, I had a doubt in the last exercise homework. question 27. 27th question.
27th question. What happened in that?
Okay, ma'am, in just, the fourth
just,
part.
Just 1 minute. This is to all the children. I hope today's class is clear with everybody. No doubt. You'll be able to solve and I'm sure all the homework sums. Okay, before we meet on Thursday. Now next class will be Thursday where we will make use of, again I'll tell you what, we'll be making use of the last four formulas which we have written for exercise 3A. So by heart those and be ready with the third exercise to start. Now Nishchal, I'll take it with you. The last part question is 27 a square plus 1 upon a square. Are you having doubt over there, Vita?
No, ma'am. In the exercise 3A, 27th question,
yes,
the last part I'm getting the answer as 27, but in the answer key it is 3 root 3. So,
is everybody getting the same thing? Is everybody getting 3 root 3 as the answer for 27th, fourth part of 3A exercise? What is the first part answer? It is A minus 1 upon A. Is it 5, Nishchal?
5. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I square it both the sides. Chalo, let's do it now only. So this will become A square plus 1 upon A square minus 2. Right? Will be what? 25. So A square plus 1 upon A square, 25. When I take it on this side, becomes plus 2. So the answer is 27. Did you get 27?
Yes, ma'am.
So the answer behind can be wrong. So good job, you have got the correct answer.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Welcome. So with this, I hope everybody is clear. Okay? So we will continue in the next class. Oh, Baba, I can see Rucha, Vanshika all raising their hands. So let me just clarify their doubt before I leave.
Ma'am.
Yes, Vanshika.
Ma'am, could you please solve the 14th question, part 2, case 2?
Part 2, case 2, 14, part 2, case 2. Part 2, case 2, again, right now I explained to our Anushka, na bitta? The same thing.
Ma'am, I'm not able to solve it.
Okay. I'll solve it for you. If I'm not mistaken, it was x plus 1 upon x. I'll be taking minus root 3. I'll cube both the sides. So I'll get x cube plus 1 upon x cube plus 3. X plus 1 upon x. Answer of this is minus 3 root 3. X cube plus 1 upon x cube plus 3. Minus root 3 inside. Minus 3 root 3. X cube plus 1 upon x cube. When I take this on the other side, plus becomes minus, minus becomes plus, and I get the answer 0. This is case 2.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Where did you go wrong?
Ma'am, that minus sign on the left hand side.
Ye badi na insafi hai. Left hand side mein aram se minus aur udhar ulta. Galat baat hai na, bita?
Yeah, ma'am, sorry.
It's okay, it's okay. Okay, so that's it for the day, children. See you on Thursday. Take care, be safe. Tata, bye.